Hi there, everybody. So this is part two of my stihl backpack that I went ahead and pulled apart. And this is where I went ahead and already cleaned it all up. Looks really nice and clean. And so we have basically all the parts and everything. Here is the cylinder. Clean out the bottom and stuff. Cylinder part is perfect, not bad at all. It also has the head and everything incorporated with the head. Here's the bottom part. It has a couple things to hold it together. Here's the back. This is the timing chain cover. Here is the, I cleaned up the piston and the rod and the crank. All in good shape. Now, I've not been able to figure out, but there's something right here, like a little groove in here. I'm not sure what that's supposed to be. Maybe, I don't know, I thought maybe there's a little tiny little, like little wrinkles in here, but there's nothing here, just a little groove and your basic two rings right here that would go in there. And I have them right here. And then it has your roller bearings. Now this guy has some seals, oil seals, lifters, just basically everything's right here to go ahead and put together. It only takes 4 bolts for this guy to be put together. No, not too bad. So I'm going to go ahead and start by putting in the valves are the most important thing. Push that in there and put on perfect. Put in the other valve. Spring. Okay, there we go. So I put in the valves and stuff, because you need to do this before you put in the piston, or else you won't be put it together right, you know. Okay, so next, put on the compression rings. Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put a tiny bit of oil in the seals. So here we have the completed crank assembly, piston assembly. What I like to do is I like to go ahead and put each open end over each skirt on opposite sides. So in that way we have good sealing. Don't forget to put on a little bit of oil. To lube it in when it goes in so it doesn't go as dry. That's what she said, guys. A little lube goes a long ways. So, okay. Now, okay. To go ahead and check for easy operation, so there you go, goes in and out pretty easy. Now, what I like to do with stuff, what I'm going to do next is go ahead and put in black ATV gasket material. Which usually should work really good on here. for the other side. Now, on here you can see that there's a little bit of a groove that is kind of, you know, molded in here and everything. This is to go ahead and put an ATV in there. So it'll make a little bit better of a seal. Just you don't have to use a whole lot or anything, but use pretty good. Now, on these bolts and stuff, I am not going to tighten them down all the way. I'm going to loosely tighten them a little bit. Make sure that a little bit of the gasket comes out. Because I want it to go ahead first, kind of like getting hard a little bit, maybe about 15, 20 minutes or so. I don't know, something like that. Okay, you want it to kind of like have it kind of squish out a little bit and everything, but you don't want to, I don't like to go ahead and right now clamp it down real hard and everything. What I want to do is go ahead and let it, you know, dry for a while and stuff, and then clamp it down, and then that should go ahead and give a good sealant in there. think I lost a part. Hold on. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and get back to you guys. Give me a minute.